In this video, I'm going to show you how you can record your screen using PowerPoint application. Office applications are now free to download. You just need a Microsoft Hotmail account and you should be able to install PowerPoint, which will be an app. Although there are some powerful screen recorders available, such as OBS, but some of my YouTube subscribers complain that OBS is very complex. It has a lot of options. So therefore, I decided to make this video. Only few people know that you can actually record your screen using PowerPoint. And this is what I'm going to show you in this video. But before I start, if this is your first time, my name is Tahir and I make videos about tools and technology available to students and teachers. And if you are interested in this subject, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. And now let's get started. I have opened a new PowerPoint document and I want to delete these two boxes so that I want to insert an image. And I click on insert picture. Then I select this image and click on insert. Now this image will be inserted and PowerPoint shows me a few design ideas. And I like this design, so I have chosen this design and now I click inside and now my image is inside a frame. One thing I would like to encourage you as an online teacher that whenever you get time, you should create some micro learning assets for your students and for general public. These micro learning assets are 2 to 3 minute videos on a specific topic, highly focused, highly targeted, answering only few specific questions. For example, in this diagram, I created this diagram in Canva, which is a free browser-based application. You just type canva.com, open an account, and you can create some amazing graphic designs for free. So I created this image in about 2 to 3 minutes, and I can explain few important concepts on this simple diagram. For example, corresponding angles, alternate angles, opposite angles, adjacent angles. So a lot of small concepts can be explained in a very simple diagram. And this is my example I'm going to show you. But at the same time, I want to record my video. I want to capture my screen when I'm explaining something. And luckily, PowerPoint has the ability to do that. And to record the screen in PowerPoint, you click on insert and then screen recording. And now, you will see these controls at the top of your computer screen. You can pin these controls at this location by clicking on this pin. But normally we don't do this because we want to record a cleaner video. We don't want these controls to be shown inside our screen recording. So therefore, I don't pin this. Now, first thing I want to do is select an area. I click on select area. And I only want to record this area. So I click and drag the area which I want to record. And now this is the area that will be recorded as soon as I click on the record button. Very simple. But as soon as I click on record button, these controls will disappear. And you can make them reappear by hovering over this area. Or you can simply stop the screen recording by pressing 3 keys simultaneously. And those 3 keys are Windows key on your keyboard, which has a Windows sign, Shift key and Q key. So Windows, Shift, Q. If you press all these 3 keys together, your recording will be stopped. So now I click on record. I will see this counter and after 1, it will start recording my screen. Now I can explain whatever I want to explain. I can click on draw tab. I can select a pen. I can explain to my student that this angle and this angle is a corresponding angle and there are 4 pairs of corresponding angles. The second pair is this angle and this angle and so on. Then I can highlight anything if I want, whatever I want to explain, because this will be my actual video that is being recorded. And now I can use the ruler inside the video. I can draw some extra lines, whatever I want. And then when I'm finished, I press those 3 keys together, Windows, Shift, and Q, and my recording is stopped. My recording is here, as you can see. So let me remove this. And this is my recording. And to save this recording, I click on File, Export, Create a Video. and create video. Now I give it a name, for example, video-1.mp4, and make sure that the file type is mp4, and I click save. And at the bottom of your screen, you will see this message, creating video, name of the file. It will take some time, but your file will be ready soon. And now inside my folder, my file is ready. I click on that. And now as you can see that I have recorded a perfect video. Now I can close this. Before you export this in MP4 file, you can also play inside the PowerPoint. And you can see that whether everything is fine. And then you can save this when you are happy with the output of your video. Now, once you have created this video, now if you click on that, then this format will appear. And if I click on this format, now I can format this video. If you notice the border and appearance of this video carefully, as I move from this option to the right, this will change. As you can see that this one is slightly different. It has a simple beveled rectangle. Then we have this center shadow rectangle. And then it has soft edge, as you can see. So these are different formatting options you can use as well. There is another important thing is this poster frame. And poster frame is just like a thumbnail. This will be shown on the top of the video until you press the play button. So let us put an image, and I want to put an image from my file, and I have prepared this thumbnail. So I click on that and I insert. And now this is the thumbnail of my video. So as you have seen that how easy it is to create a small video which clears few concepts for students. I have not created the full video, but you can imagine that it would have taken me just few more minutes to explain corresponding angles or alternate angles by using a simple image. So I would encourage all the online teachers that whenever you get some spare time, start creating some micro learning contents for your students and for your future courses. Because once you have 40, 50, these 2 or 3 minute videos on a particular topic, for example, mathematics, biology, physics, whatever subject you teach, if you have few micro learning videos, then after few months, your course will be ready. And on my channel, you will find many videos about how to create online courses. But this is the simplest way. If you don't have an expensive camera, if you don't have a lighting setup, you can create these micro learning contents simply by using PowerPoint. You can also crop the video. If I click on this crop, and it will show me these controls from where I can crop the video. So this is another option available. There are few more you can explore here. For example, you can give a shape to your video. Let's say I give this shape of my video will change. There are some video effects in this, and you might like any of these. For example, this one, it will give you a little effect around the edges. So you can explore these features if you want. Microsoft PowerPoint has a lot of features for editing videos, but most importantly, you learned in this video how to record your screen using PowerPoint application. I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and see you next time.